Hey, what's going on guys? My name is Alex and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how to upgrade to Windows 11 for free. And before I start, make sure you enable subtitles on my videos to understand whatever I say. So yeah, let's start. This video is going to be very simple. You will not need any ISO files or anything like that. We'll upgrade to Windows 11 by going to the Windows 10 settings and by going to the Windows Insider program, which you will see in a little bit. So let's get started. What you will need to do, of course, is going to open the Windows 10 settings, which will be in the start and then settings right here. Then after that, you will need to go to update and security, as you can see in the bottom middle. Then after that, in the left side, click where it says at the bottom Windows Insider program. And once you click that, it should say get started right here. And what you simply need to do, click get started. And here it says that you will need to link an account. If you click that, it's going to give you the option to log in to one of your Microsoft accounts. If you do not have a Microsoft account, then you will have to create one right now, because otherwise you cannot like log in with your Google account or something like that. You will specifically need to log in with your Microsoft account. My account right here, it is blurred at the moment because I do not want anyone to contact me on that email. And yeah, once you have created your account or you have logged in, select the account and click continue. Give it a few seconds, it says this won't take long. And here you will see three options. The ones are release preview channel, beta channel and dev channel. To upgrade to Windows 11, you will need to select the dev channel as it says here. It says ideal for highly technical users. Be the first one to access the latest Windows 11 builds earliest in the development cycle with the newest code. There will be some rough edges and low stability. So basically, you upgrade to the Windows 11 dev channel, which basically means that developers are still working on that Windows 11 build, but you will be getting constant updates. So yeah, what you simply need to do, you need to select on top of dev channel and then click confirm. Click again confirm right here. And finally, what you will need to do is going to be restart now. I'm gonna restart my virtual machine. And after you restart your virtual machine or computer, whatever you have, you will see that the Windows Insider program will be activated or enabled. And after that, if you check for updates on Windows Update, you will see that the Windows 11 update will pop up. And you will see it in a bit. I'm back to Windows Update right now, and if we go to Windows Insider program, you will see that, as I said, Windows Insider program will be activated. If you want to opt out from the Windows Insider program, just click right here the off button and turn it to on, so that, as it says, stop getting preview builds. Or if you want, you can unlink your Microsoft account by clicking on top of it and clicking unlink. But right now, if we go to Windows Update and we click check for updates, it will take about around 1 or 2 minutes or even less. And after it has found the update, you will see that it will say something about Windows 11. You will see it in a little bit what I'm talking about. And yeah, as you can see right here, it took around 10 seconds and it says Windows 11 Insider Preview, this build number right here, and it says co-release. So basically right now it will start downloading, and after that it will start installing Windows Update. And fun fact, this section right here took for me around 1 hour and 15 minutes. This will heavily depend on how fast your computer is and how fast your internet speed is, because the downloading part will use all of your internet. And if you have a very slow internet, unfortunately, this downloading part right here could literally take you 4 to 5 hours or even more, because the Windows 11 ISO file in general is around 5.5 gigabytes, which is quite a lot. So yeah, if you have a slow internet connection, then you're basically done out. And after the downloading part finishes, it will come up the installing part. And yeah, as I said, the downloading and installing part took for me 1 hour and 15 minutes. And after it tells you to restart your computer to do the Windows 11 upgrade, from there it will take you around 1 more hour or so. So technically, this will be around a 2.5 hour process. But it will be worth it if you don't want to download a dodgy ISO file from a dodgy website. And yeah, right now I'm gonna full screen the virtual machine. And yeah, this part right here will be a timestamp. For you guys, it's gonna be a 2 minutes or less timestamp, but for me, it's gonna actually be 2 hours or more. And yeah, I will see you in installation. Okay guys, I'm back and Windows 11 has finally finished installing and we are currently in the Windows 11 login screen right now, and it was actually a very lengthy process. If I remember correctly, it actually took around 1.5 hours or 2 hours. If we check OBS right now, we've been recording for 1 hour and 30 minutes, so it was actually around 1 hour and 20 minutes, which was surprising. I was expecting it to be like 2 hours or more. But anyways, here we are in the login screen right now. I'm gonna put my password, which is 123456. Doesn't really matter what password I put. And yeah, we're gonna head to the desktop right now. I'm not gonna do a review of Windows 11, of course. I've actually made a separate video about this. And if you wanna check the review that I did on Windows 11, I'm gonna leave a card in the top right corner right now. But yeah, of course, right now it's gonna take a little bit of time to head to desktop. If you do actually decide to install Windows 10 on your main machine, thankfully there's an option that if you do not like Windows 11, you can roll back to Windows 10 if you'd like, but you will have only 10 days to do so. If the 10 days mark has been passed, you will be stuck at Windows 11. So yeah, you will have only 10 days to decide if you like Windows 11. And yeah, we are right into the desktop right here. And yeah, it's pretty much the same as my previous videos of Windows 11, only something has changed. But yeah, this is Windows 11 right here. And if we go to settings and check the build of Windows 11, as you can see right here, everything has changed, which is really lovely. If we go to the About section, it says Edition Windows 11 Pro right here. And yeah, that's everything I had to show in this video. And also, something that I forgot to say in the start of this video is that in the Windows Insider program, if you do not see the option for Dev Channel, then that means that your computer may not be able to upgrade to Windows 10 straight from the Windows Update section. And that means that you will have to install Windows 11 using an ISO file. So yeah, if you only see one option and not a Dev Channel option, then as I said, you will not be able to upgrade to Windows 11. And yeah, that's everything it. That's a video guys, thanks for watching. If you have any problems, tell me in the comment section, I'll try to help you as much as possible. If you have any video ideas, tell me in the comment section, I'll try to make them in the future. Thanks for watching guys, like, subscribe and share, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!